The following program is a production of KHET in Honolulu, Hawaii Public Television.
The following program has been funded in part by grants from the Hawaii State Foundation on Culture and the Arts and the people of Chevron in Hawaii.
Spectrum Hawaii looks to John Dominis Holt and others who are at home in a field of feathers. The art of Hawaiian featherwork extends to the crafting of such objects as leis, headwear, cloaks, and capes, as seen in this priceless royal cape of King Kamehameha the Great. The art of featherwork in old Hawaii is also the subject of a new literary adventure by author John Dominis Holt.
Well, why the book, The Art of Featherwork in Old Hawaii, was that I felt that there were so many of these of articles of Hawaiian featherwork here and in other parts of the world, and that many of us had seen them here or at other places and wondered about them, wondered about what they meant and why they were made, why they were used, why they were worn. Of course, a garment is a garment. You put it on. And I thought that there were many, many unanswered questions. Why particular color combinations in capes and in cloaks? Why feather leis would have one pattern as against another pattern, and all these kinds of things. And I was fascinated by the bird lore, the catching of birds and the taking of the feathers for the making of these feather objects.
Mr. Holt's fascination with the handcrafted feather work of the late Johanna Clooney led him to purchase her collection and donate it to the Kamehameha schools for all of Hawaii's children to view and study.
All of us who work in the Hawaiian area, the area of Hawaiian culture, have had limited documentary resources to draw from. And at times we've had to, I think, use our imaginations a little bit. And I have no shame in having used my imagination in discussing some of this feather work, because it seems to me that they're obviously made with such, that they are so beautifully made, and they're made with such a depth of feeling and thought for the design aspects of the garment, that they must have been made to be used on very special occasions, and they must have been made to contain powers of a certain kind that would become those of a chief who wore that particular garment.
The teaching of feather lei making takes place every week at Bishop Museum here in Honolulu. The classes are conducted by Auntie Mary Lou Kekuewa, who for over 40 years has shared her knowledge with students of all ages and abilities.
In our classes, the thread comes from Sweden. Our clippers come from Japan. Our needles come from England. And our needle threaders are from Germany. And our feathers from New York, and we're doing a Hawaiian art. I've been asked many times if the feather work is dying out. I can say for myself that I have three generations in my home working with the feathers, so it's not. And we have so many students, and now we have so many teachers. There's classes all over. I've taught on every island but Lanai. I've taught up on the mainland. I've gone to see our sister Hawaiians that have been transplanted, needed to go up because of their husband's work, or they themselves had gone up to live, and I find that up on the mainland they band together lots closer than we do here, and they just are hungry for all of this Nāmea Hawaii. When starting, a lot of the students have no idea what they're going to do, but when they get the feel of the feather and they sew down a little ways, and they says, well, do you have another color maybe that I could add? And we have what different feathers called accents. And that person will create a lei themselves. I mean, with my little bit of help, but then they say, well, I would think that if I put the feather this way, it would look so much better. And I says, you know, you've got a good idea there. But another thing that helps my students is because we always start with a prayer. Our people always prayed and asked for help. And some of my students have come in a little bit late and they said, did you pray yet? And I said, yes, I did. Why? I've got the biggest, fattest knot. I can't get it out. Now, would you say another prayer for me? Because I know I'm going to have a bad day the rest of the day. But I says, no, I said one that included you for people that are coming and as such, you know. But they sit there and they just do beautiful work. In making of the vili poi poi lei, which means to tie feathers on to a base, we're making this particular lei called a kamoi. And what we need to do to begin with is we have a feather, a goose feather this length. And when we cut the feathers to make our lei, we get a feather of a contrasting color and use the clippers to cut the feather right here, because every feather absolutely has to be the same length. So we will take the yellow feather to continue this particular design. Place the finger under your thumb like this. Pick up your hi'a, or the thread holder, which was used before for making our fishnets. Go around all of the feathers twice. Around the figures a third time. The fourth you go around again, but come through that loop. And you're actually tying a knot on each feather. And you take the feather, turn it a little bit towards you, pick up another feather, and apply that too. Now in making the kamoi lei, we have 16 strands of yarn in comparison to the Ka'ahumanu lei, which has only 4 strands of yarn, but you need the 16 to have this nice thickness in here. Again, taking and twisting twice around all the feathers, third time around the fingers, fourth time through the loop, and tying the feather. Now to be able to realize when I get up in the morning, I have 8 hours that I'm going to reach that many more people. And to make them realize how ambitious, how ingenious the Hawaiian was in their thinking and creative, and most of all, how ambitious the Hawaiian was. Because many people do not think this, because like the visitors that come to the Bishop Museum feel that the Hawaiian only played music, danced the hula, ate and drank a lot. And I said, we do that, but then there's also a very serious part to the Hawaiian. And I'm having a part of this to educate people, which gives me a lot of satisfaction.